In this video here, I'm going to show you the accuracy of using a photometer to do your water testing. I have five PoolLab 1.0s here, and I have the exact iDip. Okay, I'm going to get a water sample here. Okay, let me go ahead and get a reading with the pH plus. For the pH plus, it's showing that the pH here is 7.73. So I'm going to use the same water sample in all the PoolLabs here. I'm going to use a syringe that came included with the PoolLab 1.0 so that all the water samples are the same 10 ml. Let me fill each meter up. And let me put the cap on all of them, and then I'll go ahead and get a zero reading. Turn all of them on. Okay, I'm going to zero them all out. Got the phenol red. I'm going to put one in each one. And these have all the same water sample. And the phenol red is used for the pH test. Let me go ahead and break up the tablet. I want to make sure the tablet is completely broken up. Otherwise the test results will be different. I'll hit pH on this one. Let me go ahead and break up the tablets and the others. And the pH is coming at 7.73 on the first one here. This one's coming in at 7.6. Slightly different. Let me do these three here. This one's coming in at 7.63 also. So both these are exactly the same as this one here. And this one's coming in at 7.59. But all within the same range of the pH here. And you can see that the pH test results are pretty close to each other. It's interesting how the first test is actually exactly the same between the pH plus and the first PoolLab that I tested. And all the rest of pH is dropping slightly. I wonder if the water sample or the pH in the water goes down rapidly as the sample sits there. I think it was about 5 minutes in between the first sample test and the last one, but still the range of the PoolLab 1.0 is really close together. So you can see that how accurate the photometer reading is for the pH reading. Okay, now I'm gonna match the five PoolLab 1.0 against the exact iDip. I'll go ahead and do the alkalinity reading and we'll compare them. Okay, let me get the same 10 ml water sample for each PoolLab 1.0. Let me power on all the units and I'll zero them out. Let me go ahead and put the alkalinity tablet in. Let me start on this side, I'll break up the tablet. Total alkalinity takes a little bit longer. Okay, I'm getting 156 here, getting 153 on this one. I got 146 here, and this one's coming in at 147, and this one's coming in at 149. I'm going to use the same water sample. I'll run the alkalinity test with the exact iDip. This testing method is a little bit different. Uses a test strip versus a tablet. And the reagent is released inside the chamber, but it reads it the same way with a photometer. And the alkalinity in the exact iDip is coming in at 146. It actually matches these two here. This one's at 146. This one's at 147. And this one's at 149.
So this testing wasn't done in a lab, so there's going to be a little bit of variation because of that fact. But you can still see that all the alkalinity readings were within range of each other, within a margin of error. And you can see that the exact iDip actually matched two of the readings, 146 and 147, really close. So you can see from these results that photometer water testing is very accurate.
So you can see that using a photometer or a digital tester is an excellent way to get an accurate reading of your pool and spa water.
InioPools.com has been helping pool owners find the right pool parts in 2001. With over 50,000 pool parts in stock, order online today and have the parts delivered right to your door. Jobber is your business's command center. The easy-to-use app powers your sales, operations, and customer service all in one place. Check the description below to save 20% off your first 6 months.